每天不断不断的修行。好，
九九流浪的河口，让你心中充满爱，不让生命受苦，这难以接受。
接下来请收看大宝法王慈悲开示。
感谢老师去给说了这话，这话那上给说了这东西，特别具有吧？这段你特别注意一点。这些看到舅舅动物这点呐，这些老毛这话刚说到天地对面去给讲，你不对吧？这段这些些老爷给他录的那些个，全部都没有给他打，主要关键这个是啥？他们这个多大个决定多？俺给这些老张干部们把钱没把，钱把没把，他们把我没把着没。他的对面的姐妹主播你是天把做不上给们了当播的老唱子了谢谢高了接着一会儿接着不要动对线领导播接着电波过年生各月中不去老唱子了我的都是叫我这个做完了嘛干嘛把一会儿过年中的时间本就一旦的就把治疗过年七分完就去上不见这边那就是这个问题的这么多这样我让这帮的这样那么这不行大概就是别的各地几百公里这种的故障都因为这差的大家来啊这差不多了呀干啥的七处地里需要的这么几多아니지난당원주디튜모기원주시디에다뉴디루지닝부루지다기란솔리아슈심비기지루도스레
So good afternoon first and then the four common preliminaries in a very short way kind of discussed already this morning
今天题目没一遍我就是啥的按照江主党都是给光电党他那心给面子党那边那种那么是用的要的
And the special preliminary we have the refuge Vajrasattva practice the mandala practiceAnd Guru Yoga, these are the four special Gendu practices.
Yes, somebody asked you. Two more, maybe, but sadi. So, I sure that. Two more, as soon as I said, two more, and doy a lambda. Just two more, and I'm done. The next day, I'm done. tūmū mūyīmbā sīdhū sāne, tūmū mūyīmbā tā sāngā kī lāṃ tā jēsū tēvā rījī sīrē.
When we talk about common and uncommon or special preliminaries, to my mind, the common means which is common to the basic Buddhist practices like Shravakayana level and all the Buddhist kind of general practices. And when we say uncommon or the special practices, which is much more especially kind of connected with the Vajrayana practice, these are the differences of what we, when we distinguish the common and special preliminaries. So although we have to talk about all the four special preliminaries, but today I think the main topic is Guru Yoga, and I feel that we will talk about Guru Yoga, and that would be more or less enough for all the other preliminaries, the special preliminaries as well. From 7th, 8th centuries onwards, the teachings of the Buddha came to Tibet, the land of Tibet. The Tibetan Buddhism, or the Buddhism that came to Tibet, is not just Vajrayana. What the type of Buddhism that came to Tibet also includes all the teachings of the Mahayana school of Buddhism, and also the basic Buddhist teachings, what is sometimes called as the Shravakayana and Pratika Buddha type level of teachings. And it's not a particular one type of Buddhism, but the complete whole teachings of Buddhism that existed in India came to Tibet, and that's what Tibetan Buddhism is.
That's ne pen pyeong sangi debalya kasura ji ta garis la da nyamchar deba chidar ngadar de chidar sa chumre deba ngadar chidar sa ne nyamchar chungse je ge ji dembe dembe ge 다가다 댐바 치더기 걸려야 되네 상하디 배 튜몽을 봐 가서 용라세네 냠수 내야지 전부 임발해서 정기요
And in Tibet, there were early translation and the later translation systems. And because of the different problems and destructions or the, some problems within the Buddhist, you know, the spread of Buddhism in Tibet, we have kind of two historical kind of waves of Buddhism. And in the later spread of Buddhism, or what we call sometimes as the later translation, the system was that...
Later translations and this German. This so much new. 사람님의 찬으로 땜방 아들시들에서 라두산 아들시라고는
The later spread the later spread of Buddhism after the kind of destruction of Buddhism earlier this system had this a way of practicing Vajrayana in a very common and a universal way
다들에 다 근육이 취해서야 돼 근육이 다 유바대에 때문에 지들이 이걸로 주무임을 해
The lineage of Kagyu also came within this later spread of Buddhism
다 강한다량 지당기 표현이 지수 다 가져와야 돼 때문에 지들이 이걸로야 다 가르쳐 다게 공비스 총비 또 주규 다들 주규 전부 시스야 라디아 때 많지야 돼 가르쳐다 때문에 시들기 겁네 다 가르쳐 우충물을 이제 차디 알아 이제 이제 삼면 나눠다 시제 차는다 양면 이제 가르쳐 상으로 집어래 뒤나 안에 다들 변한지 라멘네 조르스나 장도 야나지 가슈에 난 너는 드리슬람 주메도 다지 토마라 어르다 라마도 로멘 제바사디 게좀 싫어지기 알아서 규버강게나
and we have four main schools of Buddhism in Tibet and most of them are actually belonging to the later spread of Buddhism and all of them in all of them the Guru Yoga or in another way the relationship of or the, of teachers and students is considered very important
Terindia ngazuji kasure di nanulian zombie dan kasure jelo ma mangbuji jangan kama bukudi juru ba jadi sen jaya batang sung tuanya wajib je manja wajib arah sampun dia.
I think among you who have gathered here, I feel that there's a few people, quite few people. Who have been able to see
many people
many people who has been able to meet the 16 Karmapa and receive teachings from him And the system of recognizing tulkus or the reincarnate lamas was started by the Karmapas or it comes from the Kamapa's lineage. That's generally known.
대한다 주부 토마르디 용수 차버디 까마버디 숨바 정준도 지급리야 정준도 지디 까마바 니와 까마버시 연수리야 무진 차버네 송데 에드네 송데 다 용수 차베 주부 무진 차게 로스 총머레
And especially the third Kamapa, the Rangjung Dorje, when he was recognized by somebody else as the Kamapa, that was the kind of the first time that another
first
Lama...
First Tulku.
That was recognized in the system of recognition of the Tulkus that's prevalent now.
That's the reason, Lama Khomeyege Loma Ta Lama Khomeye Jesu Juba Tisu Kashwaya Tisu Ta Lama Tonga Sinan Jandu Tita Jesu Zimbe Chedu Ani Yangyar Kashwaya Tiki Ta Yangsi Sinan Jandu Ta Di Juba Yangyar Pene Lariang Lama the Lomian Javadi Mutun Mizijig Maimba and Mutuni Dry the Vitichi.
That's because when the Lama dies, he kind of could not give up his students. And to continue this relationship of students and teachers, thus the Lamas came back as his reincarnations. And to continue that relationship between teachers and students, that's how the system of reincarnate lamas are happening.
Today, Dusane, Lama Khomeyege, Jesu Jube, Lama Tezuge, and Lama Khomeyege, Zezushu, Zezje, Samar, Muzishu, Khomeyege, Takandar. Long the tumors and a jado, semi long the tumors is a musician. Tana said Lama the young city young and a Loma de Zu Casue Loma Teda, ya tigi bezi Gava Jemas over that digi Samuel Tantona Be Jesu Zinje, Jonga, that digi Lama the Loman Javi Mixage, that come be that Chile the tennis and a jado, come be Cuba.
And when a Lama passes away, his students tried to find his reincarnation through a system in many ways. And then this young reincarnate Lama also, continued to treat his students of the past. Students of his past life as his own students, and sometimes their reincarnations also as his students. And so this kind of life after life continuation of teacher and student relationship, that kind of special system is something that is, kind of unique in the Tibetan Buddhism.
No. Tadi kama vizijin dene chumbaji da.
This is something that's coming from the lineage of Kamapas. Something unique that is coming from the Kamapas or the Kamapas lineage.
Tadi injusane, ane jawan churu bayada karre. Yang si, 대야용 여롤야용 에너지 여롤 예외지 경화주주비에게 로마 로마 소리에 나는 신경화주주발 다가들 까만 가슴이지 그 유리다 로마 소 양간지야 두스 중대 가슴이 된제비다 다 공두슈변 나신기 로마다 로맨 제거디 gyumi jeba sinan jandu yana ben jeba samushayo deba zi kinchi gi pardu chumi toba kewa da chewe pardu chumi toba ina zi gi jeba samushayo deba zi dun tukhune samchuk
and the fact that I have due to some strong karmic relationship recognized as the reincarnation of the 16th Kamapa. And because of that, I come here as the Kamapa, and that we have this to look after and to meet the students and the centers of the Kaju or Kamakaju lineage. This is also a sign that there is a very strong and deep continuation of this relationship of teachers and students, which cannot be interrupted by death and birth. So this is something which continues even, you know, uninterrupted by even death.
That didn't do. That didn't guru yogas. That didn't do. Because Lama the Lama Jagati. 这些是physical的这些是physical的 That thing when it's negi spiritual salam jandu turn tambeji java samuji dakadar chigi dakadar kashmeji physical chibu tol maimba nasim gitola salam jandu yana karzola da tuni debit java samuji kandis yongu are sadi
So therefore this Guru Yoga practice is something that to have this very special and very strong and relationship between teacher and students. It's not just a physical level relationship that the teacher is giving teachings and students listening, but it's something even deeper than that, something a very inner spiritual relationship or very inner relationship or very kind of deep relationship which is very kind of intimate and which is not just, you know, interrupted by the, or the, which is not just a physical or thing, but it continues much deeper than that. And the relationship between the teacher and students is based on two things, basically. One is the blessings or the kindness of the teacher, and another is the devotion or the openness of the students.
라메 투지스도 단 투지스도 가르쳐 보셨나? 다 라메기 닌지야. 라메기 자와서 말해. 드리지스가 말해.
When you talk about Tukje or the blessings of the Lama, mainly it is the compassion or the affection of the teacher.
지당 안 주다. 너무 미진하다. 자와 망고 연도로 배지 밤에 불러져 왔다고 안다는 신기지 조부의 자화당 안지 산산부르 자화산 자화 망부용이요.
Generally in life we have many different kinds of affections. The affections of our parents to the children, affection of our friends, of our the family and things like that. Many different types of affections we have.
Today in Jusana, today, Lamegi, Lomalea, Zawatea, as with the Mizinangi to Zawa, Savona Taji, Chenarish Jusana, the Ketchum Shadio.
And this affection of the teacher towards the students is very, very important when we are practicing the Dharma in our life.
이래야다 라메 로마레 자와사디야 주지겐게 자와스마르베 자와 가르쇼 카시 로마 카시게 라메 자와테 지양 가르쇼에 따당 멘드비 카시게 가르쇼 지겐베 자와스마르베 오 나레 아부치도 나레 아부치 비신다지 레 아부치도 투지 쳔보던 거도 나레 능게 민도사르보 콘라베 최송송 아르 최송 마송 사르다 니주 가르베 디즈 가르베 데데 가르베다 데즈 지딘베 간다 디제 고 가르베 디텔라 라메 자와다 따당 나조 용디 요르바 다 텐담리아 라메 그 투제 자와데 아주 컨디지 무지 슈구레 사데 게 좀 그렇지 다데 메르소
and this the kindness of the teacher or the love of the teacher, the affection of the teacher, we have to understand very deeply because there are many different ways of looking at that. Sometimes, you know, we look at this affection or the love of the teacher just like a worldly love, you know, worldly affection. Then we can feel, you know, this Lama is more loving this person or more affection to this person because he's teaching him and not teaching me or doing this to that person and not too much to me. These kind of problems can come. So therefore, it is important to understand what the true kind of love and affection or the kindness of the teacher is.
Holidays and German, the Hanes Lautadi. Dunges and Swazo Mimba. Dunges Adi and a Holidays in Kinsarjun. Talabsim, let's sing the Chenunda. Kanda Kashwe and Swa Didugi, Swazo Mimba. And a Kanda Dunges Adi. 그러니까 나바상기 왜 동해래야 이제 직숨 체리어로 이제 초와 동해에서도 아주 남기 초와 이제 가서 나서 당하라 소부터 이제 그 초와 뒤로 가지 교회 동해에서 뉴스하는 다다 대회를 시 딱 한다 아주 남기 초와 기부도 주래 남기 아주 초와 내대 다도 나한테 아 초와 기부도 주 된다 초와 동해래에서 교주 때네 Then I have a music in the 레다 동해 점에 뭐 디정지엄 디기 가서 코란 사변 산한다도 코란게 네처 산한다도 데 줍제로디 레 코란 줍제 코란 안 동해게 줍제로 진 줍대 인사 디 윤선 되네 안 그러다 가서 레 동해 가라시 매치 드레스 준스다네 나도 질러
So, the teacher's affection or the teacher's love is that he sees or understands the suffering of the beings, suffering of the people. And we talk about the suffering. It's not just the sensation of suffering or the pain. It's more than that. That's the first kind of suffering, the feeling of, you know, pain or discomfort and things like that. That's the first kind of suffering. But also when we are not suffering, we are very happy or in a very kind of
pleasant
state of being. Even then, it's suffering because there's change and it's continuously, momentarily changing, and that's also suffering. And thirdly, everything that's there's a seed, or you know, the nature of everything is made of, you know, like the causes of disintegration and suffering. So therefore, you know, there's a kind of natural kind of suffering. So these three different kinds of sufferings are are being experienced by all the beings.
제자들 라멘 두지사데데데 네고기 가셔야지 말아주 소와 동해 시대장 우리 체도 말해 다가나 신기 다다데 가르시 소와 대화서면 당 아주 지 남겨지 다베는지 데스 가르 수부 대워 다나 집배저 야무 자르 니지기 가서 내가 왜 땅 원투에 대화 농원도 사마라 내 지금에 다 단도라 제 사제 대화 사는 지금 왔다 간다 남겨 가서 대화 대화를 통대야 되죠 야기에 동안 최도에 말해 대 야기에 동안 된다음 동해 야기에 동안 대화 되지 그렇지 다 네 가르사나 디 간다 동해기 자와 사는 장도 다 동해기 가르쳐다 사변 텐저부지 잡아 소문에 티체 텔이야 티체도 안 간다 공기 좀 도자와 좀 보세요 알아주 로맹원에 비나 텐는 신식 가다 티인저베 체도 가르쳐 티시베 체도 라메 투지 티체도 이 삼바르 제다 티체도 다 라메 가르쳐 마지 당화 나셔가 되지 이미냐 전제에 딱 간다라 지 코에 동해 산한다도 동해기 사변 다지 내는 용무 버티소 저가 같이 디시를 인사만 늦은 양매 작업할 때 개점이 있었어
And then kindness of the teacher is it's not just you know that to free the students or wishing of the freedom of the students from these gross problems or the pain and the sufferings. It's not only to give them like a happiness or the pleasure or the success or you know the worldly kind of progress and economic and other progress and things like that also. Because these things maybe temporarily seems like something happiness or the pleasure, but eventually it is also a source or the it's suffering, it turns into suffering. So therefore when teachers, the true kindness or the teachers really what they really wish for the students is to go to the root cause or the seed of these sufferings, and that he wishes to really uproot the cause and the seed of these sufferings, which is the klesha and the ignorance. And that's what teachers, you know, kind of aspiration or the intention is. And that's what the students also should know, that when you receive instructions and teachings from the guidance from the teacher, what he's mainly focusing on is for that how to kind of
decrease,
uproot and cut the root of the causes of the sufferings. And that's how we should see.
And the lomeng wen da mugu sa de. Mugu sa de. Mugu sa de le. Da mugu sa de chanda de ni ya de. Ji de ga shu ji. The longing de ji. Ya ba. De da ji che. Ji de and the respect de ji da ku ba sa de respect de she. Tang do la ma.
Then the devotion from the side of the students is also kind of two things. One is the longing, and another is like respect.
Two meanings.
Yeah. It has two meanings. One is the longing, and another is true kind of respect.
加上的这个，那么实际上呢，这个所说的 inspiring 什么的，这刚才这面上不是那样长度，但刚才这所说我们这里这那么提就是，他说的 inspiring 什么的吧，那你这那么是你是古话了，但原点就所说的原点前面都怕吧，那么当然心给。 但是属于遗传吧，那你这个原点的蛋白卡啥的，你这个骨啊的，那你这边就是啥呢？那这个原点的这个遗传，原点的是就是啥？那这个这看到数字吧，当看到力吧，当这个就这么一切，做的原点的，起 physical 原点嘛，难给原点，上辈原点什么的吧，但是。
And the devotion from the students is, you know, as we said, talked about the two things or the two meanings. And then when you have a teacher, you know, kind of qualified teacher, he has to be inspiring. When you say inspiring, it means that this teacher has certain qualities or better qualities than yourself, which can actually inspire you, which you see, and then it kind of steals your heart, that you have to, you know, you wish to kind of follow that or get inspired by those qualities. And these qualities are not about the physical qualities. He's beautiful or he's, you know, charismatic, not that kind of qualities, but inner qualities.
Like loving kindness.
Loving kindness and things like that.
That then you the 原点与你差不多，就是啥呢？ That 你这原点就主要的些多，那你就是说这个，就苦不切，啥难难多，贪欢切不。
So because you are inspired by those qualities, so therefore you want to aspire to actually you know, possess or develop those qualities in yourself too.
今天就是那拉玛的苦逼啥的，拉玛的这边对不住你这个当下吧，然后呢这。 那么这里啊，他说的就规矩的什么了 ，protocol 搞的规矩的说 So
this, the devotion is, and the second part, which is the respect, is also this, that this teacher's kind of qualities, the inner qualities that I would like to, develop within myself, or I would like to integrate with myself. And with that kind of understanding, then a natural strong respect or devotion or aspiration arises in you. That's what we call the devotion or aspiration. It's not that, saying good things about the teacher or just showing outside respect, because the different cultures have different ways of showing respect. The Tibetan way is something different from the Western way, and that Westerners trying to do the Tibetan way doesn't really suit very much also. And then Tibetans doing the Western way also is a little bit strange. So it's not about those outer things. It's more that inner thing, that what the great qualities that teacher has, that those positive qualities I really wish to inherit in myself, and that kind of the strong,
How much you can absorb?
How much you can absorb those qualities in yourself? And that's where the devotion, how much devotion you have, is understood. So that's why, the lineage in the like Kagyu system is this, that the teacher, tries to pass on, first train himself in the, the wisdom and compassion, and through that, develop the qualities of the teacher within himself. And then the student also try to inherit that and become possessed of those qualities within yourself. And that's what we call receiving the blessings, or receiving the lineage, and receiving the teacher's kind of the kindness and blessings. So therefore, that the training of that is the system of the Kagyu lineage, and That's what we try to work on, and that is what I understand as the main relationship of student and teacher.
제가 지금 사야되네. 근데 둘다 지금 주셔야. 지금 사야돼.
Blessing is just that to me. That is what I understand by blessing.
나는 blessings 라두사네. 나는 남주가 아주 뒤 초신에 blessings 사야돼 지가서. 다 통화 매버로 지 서머베 다지 통주를 시나면 되지. 但这样这个这就是也代表说，大家看啥不着，大家了呀？别那个说，不出去了就要比那大家旁边咋了呀？要比那？那你就旁边吃了要吧？啊，这就要比那不的去，他说，叔叔，这是他说的，叔叔的这个关键要不着不着呢？伢那就叔叔，送行。 교비에베지 미진하노다 팀 아무 총사르다 삼삼 지 미진하노다 강해름 잠도 체 유스나야 기부 담바 라마 가시 디니제야 그급 총백거야 당부 제가 루디사네 셈리아다 간다지 가르슈 남도 망부 시비지 다나시 셈 동해름 망부 이해 되버지 제 기부 담바 라마 디군디 잡네 수로 연주사네 안 등기 나라기 지가서 동해다 남도 어디서 그 장기 안게 봐 시네 안 지셈 디 수료를 차지 김진이 요 말다 수수 체드 나한테 배수게 제야 말다 장기 안기 다 한다지 기부 담바데 체베기 톱스네 안다 디녀레는 대신 셈을 시대 요네야지 근데 이 요네도 연주사네 其实不是啊，对对对，多多不这些啊，这个要嘛的，因因为呢啊，看到了那么的了呀，别人年纪越不一呢，提到的那么的啊，可怜可怜，年纪轻的用不着的。但这是准备一面呢，再来年纪轻的嘛的，现在其实不是啊的，多多多多把这些啊去，早晚的有几来什么正面都他妈些，阿拉的没些，现在啊，开始越来越难，开始啊，关门，对不起。
So this blessing, when you say blessing, it's something that you cannot see. There's nothing to be seen, but something that to be received. That's what I feel. And I sometimes feel that when they are the children and their parents, the parents are with the children. Although the parents don't do anything, but the children feel that they are being under protection, and they feel certain kind of confidence and certain kind of protection. I feel that is also a kind of blessing. So when you receive blessing from the teacher or from a lama, this is something which actually happens in my life also. Like I have sometimes difficulties, you know, a little bit disturbed state of mind and lots of things going on in my mind. And then I go to see one of the lamas or the teachers. And then after discussing things with him or just being with him for a while, then without doing anything special about those things, when I come back, then my mind is, you know, peaceful, and all those disturbances of my mind and all these things just get specified, and I feel very good and, you know, relieved and in peace. I feel that is blessing. And this kind of blessing is in a way when a lama has lots of compassion and kindness and all these kind of positive qualities, then, you know, somehow the people who, the students, slowly, you know, step by step, also in a way absorb those qualities in yourselves. And that is what I feel is blessing. I don't know any other blessing than that. That, I think, is my blessing. If somebody else has something else, which is called blessing, that you can just, as some object, that something that you can actually give somebody, then I don't know about it.
Materialism. 소말로다 슈처머를 자리 여빈사 미강갈지 지 고스데 람산지 람사 따도야 여더버지 단지 람산지 가르레 가서 이제 도도를 지 여거나로 샤데 망고시다요니 제상 아줄디 패션스 나타도 능규 정도디 야마레 쇠센디 매브체 이나 아주 지 취역이 지럽사디 되게 공도 주변에시 동도시지 삼성지지는 아주 간단 드림 20세기에 나눠내야 신외비 토레베 인을 수다 취제 아니 삼목 리스탐이네 딕 토레야 직접되고 다 레라고 단드는 가라지 지수 지 사주 전부다 내 삼당데 디 난게 냠네 제베급이야 근데 이제 삼당나 그런 조단데 미지거름 좀 차는 것도 좀
In this 21st century, we have become very materialistic. So therefore, we sometimes, you know, regard this blessing also something like a material thing, that I want it and then the teacher gives it and then now I've got it. And something like that. This is not the way, you know. It's not something, the blessing is not something that you kind of just give it and then you get it and then it's finished. It's not something like that. It's a kind of a long-term thing. It's an influence which kind of slowly builds up. Maybe you have met a Lama and received teachings 3 years, you know, and then for a long time there's nothing, you don't have anything special, you know. You don't think it was something, anything special. But maybe after maybe 3 years, then you recall back that meeting or the teaching of the Lama, and then you feel that, you know, something happened that time. So these kind of things, you know, it sometimes takes time. It's not not the material way of doing things. We have this very strong material kind of mentality, so we think that Dharma practice also is done in that way, that you just give something or receive something or just, you know, done like that. It's not the that way. The Dharma practice and then the material way of giving and taking is not the same system. It's totally different one. Because sometimes we don't have too much patience. We just want it now, and then, you know, you just go and get it from the Lama and Lama just give it. It's not that way. It doesn't happen in that way. It has to be something that has to be slowly cultivated and happens in a like slowly absorbing those qualities within yourself.
Okay. Da ba ji ni ni ji ji mi da. Da xi da xi ji leng guru yoga si le bi san chang sa ji yoga si le bi san ne la sa ri chu lu da bi ji. Ya na ji ka ru bi ji che gua na lu sha de. Da cha sa yoga sa de ni de mi ba ta han da. Ne ju ram. 아니 바지 뒤주 드리지 마자 아니 가수에 와야 담지죠.
And Guru Yoga, you know, is when you say yoga, sometimes you feel that there's something, a ritual, something that is to be done. I think it's not like that. It is this kind of understanding and practice within. That is the real kind of essence of the Guru Yoga. I feel that that's the essence of it. Maybe there is nothing much more to say about this. So I think I will just stop here about Guru Yoga.
And then you start to drink the ping yang, yang some lo, tarum buni, mamuji tarum buni yong. And me say that kashwe, kange mamukyen si de peyare, gawish tashums, shuai.
And all of you have come from very far away places, and you have endured lots of hardships and difficulties for coming here and being here also. So I'm very happy that all of you could come here and I could meet you. And from my side also, I've tried a long time and many times with difficulties to come here. We actually made 4 attempts to come to Europe. The first time we made an
Officially four times.
First time we made the attempt to go to various countries of Europe, and that didn't happen. Then second time, we tried to go to 2 countries, and that also didn't happen. And third time, we tried to go to only Germany, and that also didn't happen. And then when we made this 4th attempt, I didn't even expect it to happen. It was a little bit like a dream. But now that finally it could happen, and I am here, and I'm really very happy and very grateful about that. And as I said before, so it is something which is a result of lots of efforts and difficulties. So I feel it is a very special thing and something which is very important for me, and so I'm very, very grateful and happy about that.
Thank you. Thank you.
护持中华印经协会。 邮政划拨，户名中华印经协会，划拨账号19658482 19658482，银行账号，银行代号土地银行005，账号012-001-194-788012-001-194-788，护持印证经书、佛书、经幡、结缘品。
借最大的福，生最大的善，走跟生命电视放生去，走跟生命电视放生去。
接下来请收看般若讲座。
今日见到香山斑马给咱的同胞了，杨春说过我祝你斑马中的喜色的过得很关注我们不过几几几次到处去寻迹了，不要下次送给了斑马色的我祝人个人参加当这不能曾经不去下次你有这边的这前我就老做老做软的做寻迹了，现在上海把技术上百元的把他们找到的梦我祝做这人个人参加当这不能曾经不去下次你有这边当这前我就老做了苏软的苏心机了，现在上海把技术上百元的把他们找到的梦我祝做这人个人参加当这不能曾经不去下次你有这边当这前我就老做了苏软的苏心机了，现在上海把技术上百元的把他们找到的梦我祝做这人个人参加当这不能曾经不去现在上海把技术上百元的把他们找到的梦我祝做马红把整个的把马色动马红把整个的把马色动马红把整个的把马色动马红把整个的把马色我马红把整个的把马色动马红把整个的把马色动马红把整个的把马色动马红把整个的把马色动马红把整个的把马色动马红把整个的把马色动我们把这个人把马子的话接了的江苏的话在边地的说刚才那边在江苏那当我们在做些话的就当改进别人咋的说中等点广播家伙人要拉响咋路刚刚路住着你正着你的难道老师今年冬天就算是些人你记得个老老我们在那个那这边做了马人们都等我来解释跟喇叭就打这样老就这样等送这都是接着你摸你弄你接着都等着马里个门塞的等我们一个今年就在拉着呢等你到场三平的送人等你走街这头是找着当时你眼睛到路门塞人讲话了样懒得的最多呢几斤接着我塞的到路的门门把着着你我当当就用了多把露珠不必那我觉得说娘姐见不走的你没想送你母亲见不俺家把个人当俺赞度什么都能把自己将来想赞了
第二个啊，伦理道德啊，伦理道德上面伦理道德上啊，就是有非常大的帮助。比如说啊，中国传统文化是儒释道啊，那么除了舍啊，除了这个佛法以外啊，儒家的思想啊，就是强调做人的方式啊，就是这很多很多的这些伦理道德。但是这个伦理道德呢啊，人类的伦理道德或者是我们某一个民族或者是某一个地区的这个伦理道德呢，就是建立在啊，或者是某一个村庄啊，或者是某一个家庭他们的这个伦理道德建立在他们自己的价值观的基础上啊，价值观的基础上。但是人类的价值观啊，就是通过人类的这个历史啊，经过人类跟着人类的历史会有变化的啊，会有变化。 啊，这是为什么呢？刚才我们提到的，人和狗刚刚从这个不吃不喝关了五天以后出来放出来的时候呢，第一个时间他们两个都认为啊，最有天下最值钱的东西啊，最值钱的东西啊是什么？不是宗教，不是音乐，不是艺术，不是金银珠宝，都不是，是什么？就是食物，可以吃的东西是最值钱的啊。那这个时候他的价值观就是这样子。这个时候如果有人说啊，吃食物啊，食物不是最值钱的啊，宗教是最值钱啊，他是肯定是会反对的啊，人和狗都会反对的啊。如果这个100个人出来了，100个人都是五天没有吃没有喝这种人的话，那么他们都会反驳，在他们的面前，我们说啊，天下最值钱的啊，最有用的是啊，钻石啊，金银珠宝啊，那他们会反驳的。他说不是的，是什么？就是啊，这个食物，但是。已经过了这个阶段以后，他还会这么说吗？啊，人不会这么说的。这个时候，人这个时候就会说啊，因为物质的东西他已经解决了，他认为不怎么需要了，他已经忘了过去的这个历史啊，他认为不怎么需要。那需要什么呢？他会说没有得到的东西，离他比较有距离的东西，他会说这个是最值钱的。所以我们的伦理道德是这个人类的历史的这个变化而变化的啊，所以1000年前啊不能做的啊，做了是一个大家都认为是一个非常缺德的事情啊，这样子的东西，1000年之后呢啊，它不是一个缺德的事情，而是一个很正常的事情啊，这有可能的啊，所以是。但是靠不，我的意思就是说它靠不住的啊，人类的价值观会有发生变化，那么有了变化以后呢，这个价值观是伦理道德的基础啊，它的基础有变化，那它当然会有变化的，所以这个是没有伦理道德呀，它是短暂的，它是没有太大的这个说服力的啊，没有太大说服力。比如说我们一部分人认为这样子做是缺德的事情，不能这么做，但是另外一部分人呢觉得这个没什么的呀，可以这样子、啊、他会的，所以这个没有一个共同的观点，所以不是伦理道德啊。那是什么呢？真正的啊，能够这个在伦理道德上面呢啊，比如说什么是可以做啊，什么是不可以做，这个是最这个原因啊最有说服力的，还是我认为是在这个宗教里面啊，尤其是像佛教里面，比如说佛教里面啊，他说的他制定的有十条罪果啊，也就是我们今天讲的负能量啊，负能量有10个代表性的，杀盗淫妄是这4个。是所有的这个罪过的最基本的东西，所有罪过的基础，基本最根本的就是杀盗，就是偷盗，淫啊就是破坏别人的家庭啊，破坏别人的感情啊，杀盗淫妄就是欺骗诈骗啊。那么佛教把这4个是认为是这个最缺德的啊，最这个啊最这个所有罪的根本啊。那为什么这4个是缺德呢？啊，它不是人的，这个人的价值观是没有关系的，这个是一个施舍啊，施舍。比如说我们啊，所有的人啊，是所有的人，什么东西啊，天下什么东西我们当作是最有其最最最这个珍贵的呢？啊，那当然是我们自己的生命呢啊，财产啊，名声啊，地位啊，这些东西平时对我们来说是很重要，但是呢，因跟我们的命相比的话，那这些东西都是不值钱的。那这东西当中呢，所有东西当中，如果我们只允许保留一个东西，那我们会选择我们的命啊，其他东西我都可以没有，但是不能没有我的命啊。那么杀是什么意思呢？去剥夺啊别人的生存权。啊，生存权， 所以这是天下最大的这个罪过啊！这不是跟人的价值观有关系啊，这跟人的风俗习惯是没有关系的，这是直接啊跟人的一个这么痛苦一个实实在在的东西有关系，所以这是最有说服力的，是这个佛教里面讲的这些伦理道德啊，像杀啊、盗，为什么不能盗？人除了人自己的名以外，然后呢，他的这个身外的东西是对他来说是最重要的啊，最重要的。那么这个是无因无缘的去剥夺啊别人的合法的这种私有的财产啊，那么这个是最。最大的这个罪过啊，然后第三淫是什么呢？就是破坏别人的家庭啊，破坏别人的家庭。破坏别人的家庭是说，比如说无因无故的去破坏别人的家庭啊，那么破坏了这个家庭以后呢啊，比如说这个他们的孩子啊，还有他们的这些老人啊，就把这个家庭破碎了以后呢，对他们都是一个这个家庭的这个破碎啊，对这个家庭的成员来说是一个非常大的打击啊，是一个打击。除了名和财产以外啊，这个是他们最需要的啊，最需要的。所以去剥夺了这个啊，这东西以后呢，然后这是一个对别人的一个最大的伤害，因为这些东西都是直接对别人有伤害，所以它是罪。这个并不是我们大家都，因为我们的习惯就是这样子，所以你不要去违背这个习惯，它不是这样子的，这个不是习惯的问题，这是一个事实的东西啊。所以，比如说不杀生啊，不偷盗，如果这仅仅是一个伦理道德的话，那么伦理道德什么时候都会有变化的。但是它不是伦理，它是因为直接跟人的痛苦和幸福有关系，所以它不能去啊，他认为这是罪啊，等等啊。所以我们比如说在我们的生命当中有信仰啊，还有就是比如说我啊，身心这个佛教所讲的因果啊，佛教的因果就是善有善报，恶有恶报啊！这种学说，我是从骨子里面我去相信这东西的话啊，就是有很多很多的好处啊。什么好处？第一个啊，我本人的这个道德的底线啊，底线我一定会有这个底线啊啊。但是呢，我们今天比如说啊，我们最不会做的是什么？啊，近现代人，那、我们掌握了很多很多的这个技术啊，我们掌握了很多很多的知识啊，我们就是信息时代，每一天都吸收很多很多的这个信息啊，但是我们最不会做的，就是我们最不会做人啊，现在是这样子的问题了，最不会做人，越来越看不到我们的道德的底线啊，道德底线，就像我们食品领域当中呢，就是出了这么多的问题，其他不说啊，人吃的东西啊，里面出这么多问题，如果这些人身心因果啊，坚定不移的相信善有善报，恶有恶报的话，那么地沟油会产生吗？啊，毒奶粉会有吗？啊，等等，以及其他这些都会有吗？不会有的，至少这些是不可能有的事情，但是因为我们没有这种观念呢，没有什么，我们只怕法律啊。但是呢，法律是非常有局限性的。为什么？只要我知道啊，我违法了啊，才会啊受到这个法律的惩罚啊。如果我没有人知道了，那我怎么会有这个惩罚呢？啊，所以绝大多数的95%的这个犯罪的人啊。他的心态是什么呢？他以为这个是没有人知道的啊！如果他觉得有人知道，他会还这样子吗？不会的啊！极少数的啊，已经是走投无路的呀，或者是非常非常就人生走到一个非常啊低的这个低层的这种人呢，就已经是无所谓了，就吸毒了、酗酒了，无所谓，他就觉得知道也不知道就无所谓。啊，但是这个人呢，就是比如说100个人犯法，那么其中就只有1-2个人才是这样子，其他人的心态，他认为是没有人知道的。如果他认为他确定这个有人知道，他不会这么做的啊。所以， 一开始的时候呢，他认为没有人知道，所以他就会做这件事情啊。但是英国就不是这样子，英国这个不是有人知道，没有人知道，这英国呢是什么原理呢？就我们的这个意识啊，最低层的这个意识，它就像我们的这个电脑的这个硬盘一样啊。然后我们的煞到阴王啊，都是负能量啊，负能量，然后不傻不倒啊，还有帮助人呐、扶贫慈善呐、这些都是正能量啊，正能量啊。然后把我们的这个储存起这个硬盘里面呢，就输入的东西、储存的东西都是负能量啊。这样子的话，那么这些东西总有一天它会散发出来的啊。那么负能量的这个散发一定是负能量，负能量储存了以后呢，不可能散发出正能量啊，这个是不可能的啊。正能量储存了以后呢，也不可能散发出负能量，这叫做善有善报，恶有恶报啊。就像我们所讲的这个种瓜得瓜，种豆得豆，就是这个原理。那我们的意识当中储存了这么多的负面的东西以后呢，这个跟别人知道和不知道是没有关系的，没有关系啊，这是一个自然的啊，一个自然的规律啊。这些负的东西储存的多了，它就散发出来，就是负面的东西啊。那么这个负面的东西是一个非常消极的、悲观的、痛苦的一个这样子的东西啊。所以，如果我坚信这个原理的话啊，那我绝对不会啊，不会储存更多的负能量。有些时候我们理论上知道，但是呢，因为我们控制不到自己的情绪啊，有些时候明明知道这个不可以这样子，但是我们控制不了自己，会偶尔会这个储存一些负能量啊。但是呢，储存完了以后呢，我们还是会想办法啊，把这个删除啊，这个负能量会产，这叫做佛教，就这叫做这个忏悔啊，忏悔。会这样子，但是不相信因果的话啊，不相信因果的话，那么这样子的话，反正没有人知道的话，那我这个没有什么可以做和不可以做啊，只有允许做和不允许做，没有一个是可以做和不可以做啊，只有允许和不允许，没有可以和不可以啊。凡是啊不允许的东西呢，没有人看的，有人看到的时候，在众目睽睽之下是不允许的。但是呢，没有人知道我一个人的时候呢，这谁来控制我啊？这个时候必须要有这个因果啊，这种信仰啊。有因果的话，第一个对我们的这个伦理道德，我觉得是非常有帮助的啊。然后呢，我们社会的每一个成员啊，我们每一个人，我们普通的老百姓和这个官啊，政府官员以及其他的这些各种各样这个啊，这个企业家，都变成这样子的相信因果的人啊，这样子的话呢，那我们的这个社会才是真正的这个和谐的社会啊，不会有什么地沟油呀啊，这个杜莱芬啊等等的现象，不会有的啊，这是一个。另外一个，比如说我们家庭的成员有三个人或者五个人啊，那么我们五个人都是坚定不移的啊，相信这个善有善报，恶有恶报。那这样子的话，这个家庭会是什么样子？这个家庭当中会不会出什么很缺德的事情？不会的啊。所以第一个对伦理道德很有帮助啊。第二个。对我们的遭遇，比如说我们在这个现实社会当中，这个激烈的竞争啊，这个当中呢，有些时候我们都需要面对很多很多非常不公平的待遇，这时候呢啊，我们没有一个东西，没有一个理念可以安慰我自己的啊，比如说我生病了，绝症啊，癌症晚期了。啊，那这个时候，这个虽然不是一个什么不公平的待遇，这是因为我自己的饮食呀、身体的原因。但是呢，我们会说啊，我们很多很多人说，为什么是我呢？为什么轮到我的头上呢？啊，我们会说啊，那么你认为这个应该轮到谁的头上呢？啊，我们肯定会说，反正不应该是我 啊，我们看见啊，这个是什么？就是这个时候我们没有一个东西来说服自己的啊。那么越是这样子以后呢，啊，我只有就是比如说我们十个同事当中呢，就我得了癌症啊，然后这个对我来说是一个非常不公平的事情。这样子以后呢，除了这个肉体的啊痛苦以外，精神上的痛苦啊是一个非常严重的痛苦了啊，严重的痛苦啊，然后这个精神上的痛苦就把这个啊这个癌症肉体上的痛苦更加的恶化啊，更加的恶化。本来是可以活五年、两年、三年的，但是呢，因为这些负面的情绪积累积的多了以后呢，直接影响到他的这个病情的恶化啊，然后缩短自己的生命。如果相信因果的人，他会怎么样看呢？啊，他一定会告诉自己啊，我这个我们十个这个同事当中，我得癌症了啊，那这个肯定是我过去去杀生啊。杀人啊，杀人啊，这个有关系啊，这个国宝啊，我今天就是有自己的国宝。那么其他的我的九个同事啊，他们没有做这样子的事情，那、啊、所以他今天没有得这个癌症啊，那这是没有什么不公平，这是我自己啊，是我自己没有做对啊，是我自己的这个宝银啊啊，这样子一定会啊。说服自己，这个也许是我们过去的这个业啊，这个报应，也许不是报应啊，是因为我自己的这个环境呢、啊，我自己的这个饮食呀啊这些有关系，也许是跟这些有关。但是事实是什么啊？这个我们没有办法确定。但是至少你这样子去想啊，你把我们的精神上的这个痛苦是完全是可以消除的啊。精神上的痛苦消除了以后呢，啊，然后呢，他对他的这个病情也有帮助的，啊，也有帮助。所以啊，这是一个比喻啊。除了这个以外，我们在现实生活当中经常都遇到各种各样的不公平的待遇啊。那么不公平，我们每次遇到这个不公平的待遇的时候呢，我可以啊。这个人对我不公平等等这种说法以外，我可以找另外一种解释的方法啊，另外一种解释的方法啊。为什么我这样子呢？其他不是，比如说我的领导啊对我不好啊，对我的同事很好，他对我不好啊。那我们平时就是说因为领导不公平啊，我们会这样子啊。但是呢，相信因果的人呢，他会啊，除了这个以外呢，他再去思考另外一个啊，另外一个解释的方法。为什么呢？他为什么对其他人不是这样？对，为什么偏偏跟对我这样子呢？啊，那是肯定是我过去啊，对他啊，以这种方式去对待过，所以我今天我轮到我头上了啊，等等，他会这样子啊，安慰自己。这也许是一种纯粹的安慰，但是呢，啊。无论是他是安慰也好，是有道理的也好，没有道理的也好，反正通过这种方法啊，他对这个的不满啊、抱怨、仇恨这个问题是从根本上就解决了，根本上解决。其实这个人对我的不公平的待遇，在我的从我的精神的角度来讲啊，是根本没有我没有面临这个不公平的待遇是一样的啊，一样的结果了啊。所以对自己的啊，比如说我们面临痛苦啊，面临不公平的待遇啊，面临这个病啊等等的时候，这个因果关系是非常非常有说服力的一个东西啊啊。然后另外一个更好的是什么呢？啊，更好的是，比如说我们十个人当中，我生病了，我的同时都是很健康，他们还是高高兴兴的啊，拥有健康的生活，还是在高高兴兴的上班啊。那这个时候呢，如果有这种佛教的这种训练的话，那我很愿意的啊，我就是因此而我会高兴的。为什么呢？啊，就是我生病了啊，他们没有生病啊，我很高兴啊。然后呢？我不但是高兴，而且我可以啊发自内心的许愿啊我的同事家人啊，或者是我不认识的这个城市里面的所有的人啊，他 他们的这些啊，就像我跟我一样的这些兵啊，这个痛苦啊，我愿意我一个人来承担啊，发自内心的发愿，以我的这个痛苦来消，能够消除所有人的痛苦啊，他会这样子。这个时候呢，他心里不但是没有不高兴，而且真的是这样子啊。这个我们可能是没有学佛的人，可能很多人觉得这个不可能的啊，甚至是我觉得有些人会嘲笑啊，其实不是这样子，不是这样子。我们的精神是可以被训练的啊，可以被训练的，而且我们的精神的力量是非常的不可思议的啊。如果他这样子换位的思考啊，他为了啊这个别人的健康而感到感到幸福啊，这样子的话，那么就是通过这种力量啊，通过这种力量，通过这种心灵的神奇的力量，有可能消除他的这个啊，全世界的医院治不了的病，有些时候是莫名其妙的这种啊，这种方法去啊消除啊，就是一，这叫做一念啊，一念，通过一念的力量把癌症都啊治好的这种例子，这种公案是非常非常多的啊，很多的，所以这个时候信仰啊对我们有这样子的帮助，我想我们相信这个啊，相信这个有这个帮助啊，只相信因果，这也是我们信仰的一部分，这是第一啊。第二啊，然后第三啊，第三啊啊，这个死亡的时候啊，因为我们的时间的关系，我们就这个信仰对我们的这个帮助，现实生活当中看得见摸得着，我们自身能够感受到的这些对我们的利益啊，我们可以讲20个、30个、50个都没问题。但是因为我们的时间啊，我们在最后再讲一个啊，最后一个是什么呢？啊，就是这个啊，死亡啊，我们面对死亡的时候啊，这是一个非常非常关键的时候，真正的心灵的考验的时候，就是死亡的时候啊。那在这个之前呢，啊，我们会说这个对我有需要，这个也需要，那个也需要。有些时候我们认为什么都不需要，有些时候我们认为什么东西都需要啊。但是真正走到这个地步的时候，我们才发现我真正的需要的是什么啊。这个时候我才发现啊，我的生命当中真正的我需要的啊东西是什么，这时候会发现的。这是一个真正的一个心灵的考验啊。那我们以什么样的方法去面对啊，面对这个死亡，这时候有信仰的人和没有信仰完全是不一样的啊。你们可以看一本书叫做这本书的题目叫做追逐日光啊，追逐日光啊。那么这个是一个这个美国的企业家写的啊，他是全美的最大的私家会计公司的总裁啊，他的每年的收入是40到50亿美金啊，然后他们的公司拥有20000名员工啊，一个这样子的大公司的总裁。他很年轻的时候，53岁的时候啊，一体检的时候，医生就告诉他啊，他这个脑里面就有一个恶性的瘤子啊，然后癌症已经是晚期了，没办法啊。医生就说他只有3个月的时间，只有3个月时间。但是呢，他是一个非常啊这个虔诚的一个宗教徒啊。我想从他的书来看的话，他本身是一个基督徒，但是呢，他也间接的接触过一些这个藏传佛教的一些这个上师啊，所以我想他的这个信仰当中啊，这个背景是有主要是啊这个西方的宗教，然后好像也有一些这个佛教的东西。不管怎么样，他是一个很虔诚的一个这个这样子的人。那么他就在最后的3个月的这个时间啊，利用最后3个月的时间，他就写了一本书啊。 这个就叫做追逐日光啊，追逐日光。那么他的书的这个啊，第一行里面的第一句话是什么啊？他说：“我很幸运啊，医生说我还可以活三个月啊。”这个是他的第一句话啊。然后他从头到尾这三个月啊，他说他要把这个三个月要做到他的生命当中的最完美的啊，最完美的时光啊。那么这个怎么样去做最完美的时光呢？他也自己也说了，就是因为他的信仰啊，他的信仰一直都在支持他最后的这个三个月可以变成他的生命当中的真正的真正的这个是这个最完美的这个时光。他说他在这个之前是一个非常非常忙碌的人啊，他有一次就寻找一个亚洲的一个大银行的一个总裁，他见一个，但是他寻找一个客户，然后从美国就坐20几个小时的这个飞机，然后就正好这个银行的行长就在这个飞机上，就是为了赶到这个时间啊，就在飞机上谈了2个小时，然后飞机降落了以后呢，然后他立即又飞到这个美国，就是一个这样子的一个非常忙碌的一个工作狂啊。那么他说我真正的就是感受到人的这个生活的这个时光呢，其实也就是最终的这三个月啊。因为这个之前呢就是这么的忙碌，加班工作狂，根本就没有时间去这个去陪家人啊，轻松啊，自由啊，这都没有时间了。后来他就是他说把这个要做到最完美的啊，然后他的信仰一直都在支持他，一点都没有这个不开心的。这就是一个普通人啊，这不是高僧大德，这不是佛菩萨，他是一个普通的信徒啊。我的意思就是说，如果我们没有信仰的人啊，没有信仰的人，就是一辈子这么奋斗，这么努力啊，这么忙碌啊，就是当他到了53岁的时候然后呢，就是立即说啊，他只有三个月的时间，那会是什么样子呢？啊，一定会崩溃的，但是他深深的相信，他和他的家人一定会在天堂会碰面的啊。天堂到底碰不碰面不好说啊，但是至少他就是这么认为的啊，这种。